Good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Abhay Deshpande, Associate Professor, Army College of Engineering, Bangalore. And today is my sixth lecture on Unit 5. And the concept is skin effect. So today's outline is the skin effect. What is the concept of skin effect we are going to learn today? Along with that, we are solving few examples and solutions. So let us start with the skin effect. So in the previous sessions, we have done the concept of propagation in good conductors. Now, according to the wave propagation in good conductors, that is, regardless of the parameter mu as well as sigma of the conductor, where sigma is the conductivity of the conductor. So regardless of the parameter mu and sigma of the conductor, or of the frequency of the applied field, both alpha and beta are equal. So if you again assume that the electric field intensity EX component is traveling in the z direction, then we can write Ex is equal to Ex naught into e to the power minus z under root of pi f mu into sigma cos of omega t minus z into under root of pi f mu into sigma. So this is based on the concept of wave propagation in good conductors. So irrespective of the parameter mu as well as the sigma, as well as the frequency of the applied field, the alpha and beta are equal. That is, attenuation constant and phase constant both are equal. Hence, the conduction current density at any point within the conductor is directly related to electric field intensity, as Jx is equal to sigma into Ex. That is, conductivity into electric field intensity, that is equal to the conduction current density. So hence we can write this as sigma as it is, and Ex value we will substitute it as Ex naught into e to the power minus z under root of pi f mu into sigma into cos of omega t minus z into under root pi f mu into sigma. So the exponential factor, if you see here, it is e to the power minus star. Hence, the exponential factor is unity at z is equal to 0. That means e to the power 0 is equal to 1. And it starts decreasing to e to the power minus 1, that is 0.368 times, whenever z is equal to 1 divided by under root of pi f mu into sigma. That means such a type of field will start decreasing. The strength of the signal's amplitude will start decreasing as the value of z is equal to 1 divided by under root of pi f mu into sigma. So it normally decreases up to the 37% as that of its original value normally. And hence, this decrease, we will call it as skin depth or else depth of penetration. That means the amplitude of the signal in such cases will start decreasing, and that we will call it as skin depth, and we will denote it as delta. We will denote skin depth as a delta. Delta is equal to 1 divided by alpha, that is equal to 1 divided by beta, is equal to 1 divided by under root of pi f mu into sigma. So this is the skin depth, or we will call it as depth of penetration. That is nothing but delta. Now we can define our intrinsic impedance eta as 1 plus j divided by sigma into delta, where delta is the depth of the penetration. That means amplitude of the wave will start decreasing because we have e to the power minus star exponentially decreasing function we have. So whenever z is equal to 1 divided by under root of pi f mu into sigma, the strength of the signal, the amplitude of the signal will start decreasing. And this concept we will call it as a skin depth. Now based on this skin depth, we will solve some simple examples. That is, the depth of the penetration, first example we will see. The depth of the penetration in a certain conducting medium is 0.1 meter and the frequency of the electromagnetic wave is 1.0 megahertz. Find the conductivity of the conducting medium. So they have given the depth of the penetration in certain conducting medium is 0.1 meter. That means they have given the depth of the penetration, amplitude is start decreasing, and finally the skin depth value they have given as 0.1 meter. That is 0.1 meter is depth of the penetration, and the frequency of the electromagnetic wave is 1.0 megahertz. Frequency of the signal is 1.0 megahertz. That means 1 megahertz, 1 into 10 to the power 6 hertz. And I need to calculate the conductivity of the conducting medium. So let us use the equation. Delta is equal to 1 divided by under root of pi f mu into sigma. And we will write it as 1 divided by under root of pi f mu. We will write it as mu naught into mu r into sigma. Now substitute all the values. That means delta is equal to 0.1 meter. That is equal to 1 divided by under root of pi as it is. F value is 1 megahertz. 1 into 10 to the power 6 into mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. And mu r value we will consider it as 1. And only the unknown value is the conductivity of the conducting medium, that is sigma. So from this we can calculate the conductivity of the medium, that is 5.0329 mho per meter. We will get sigma value as 5.0329. That means if the medium having the conductivity sigma as this, then as the z value is equal to 1 divided by under root of pi of nu into sigma, then exponential term will start decreasing, e to the power minus term. Hence, it will graze the surface, or else the depth of the penetration is equal to 0.1 meter. So at 0.1 meter, the conductivity of the medium is 5.0329. So this is how we will calculate the conductivity of the conducting medium. Let us take the second example. So here it is a reverse. They have given the conductivity and frequency and asking you to calculate the skin depth. That is, determine the skin depth for copper with conductivity of 58 into 10 to the power 6 at a frequency of 10 megahertz. So at a frequency of 10 megahertz, I need to calculate the skin depth for copper and conductivity they have given. And we know the formula for skin depth, depth of penetration as delta is equal to 1 divided by under root of pi f mu into sigma is equal to 1 divided by under root of pi f mu, we will write it as mu naught mu r into sigma. So pi f value is 10 megahertz. So 10 into 10 to the power 6 into mu r value, I will consider it as 1. And mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. And conductivity sigma they have given as 58 into 10 to the power 6, it is conductivity of the copper, and we can calculate the skin depth in meters. So we will get it as 20.898 into 10 to the power minus 6 meters. The skin depth or the depth of penetration, we will get it as 20.898 micrometers. That is the depth of the penetration for copper at a frequency of 10 megahertz. Let us see the next problem, example number 3, that is a 160 megahertz plane wave penetrates through aluminium of conductivity 10 to the power 5 epsilon r equal to mu r is equal to 1. Calculate skin depth and also depth at which the wave amplitude decreases to 13.5% of its initial value. So we need to calculate the skin depth and also depth at which the wave amplitude decreases to how much percent? 13.5% of its initial value. So we can calculate first skin depth, that is depth of penetration, using the formula. Let us write the given data first, substitute, and then calculate the value of delta. So that is delta is equal to 1 divided by under root of pi f mu into sigma pi into frequency value is 160 megahertz, that is 160 into 10 to the power 6 into mu value is mu naught into mu r, mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, mu r value they have given as 1 into conductivity is 10 to the power 5. Substitute this and calculate the value of delta. And we'll get delta value is equal to 125.823 micrometers. We will get delta value as 125.823 micrometers. But for good conductor, as it is given that for aluminium, sigma is 10 to the power 5. So which is very much greater than 1. We can write alpha is equal to beta is equal to 1 divided by delta, that is 1 divided by skin depth. So 1 divided by 125.823 into 10 to the power minus 6 will give us the value as 7947.6725 is the value of alpha and beta. That is attenuation constant and phase constant. We will get it as 7947.6725. So we have calculated the skin depth in micrometer. Now the left out is depth at which the wave amplitude decreases to 13.5. So to calculate the depth, I have calculated the value of alpha and beta. Then, now at z is equal to z dash, the amplitude decreases to 13.5% of its initial value. Now, let us write the amplitude of electric field as amplitude E is equal to E naught into e to the power minus beta z, that is equal to E naught value. We can write E naught value, which is decreasing 13.5%. Hence, we will write it as 13.5% divided by 100 into E naught. We can equate this to 13.5 divided by 100 into E naught. Hence, now take ln on both sides. So you will get minus beta z dash into ln of E is equal to ln of 13.5, that is nothing but 0.135, 13.5 by 100. Now I will substitute the value of beta. Beta I have calculated as 7947.6725. So 7947.6725 is the value of beta. Z dash as it is, minus as it is, ln of E equal to 1 and ln of 0.135. So that is equal to, I will get it as minus 2.0025. So that is, if I calculate Z dash from this, I will get Z dash is equal to 252 micrometer approximately. That is 0.252 millimeter. The amplitude decreases to 13.5% of its initial value. So that means that is the depth at which the wave amplitude decreases to 13.5 UAs. The depth is equal to 0.252 millimeter is the depth at which the amplitude is decreasing to 13.5% of its initial value. So this is how we will calculate the depth of penetration also, and also the depth at which it is decreasing. Next question. Determine the depth of penetration for copper at 1 megahertz. So we know conductivity sigma is equal to 5.8 into 10 to the power 7. And let us assume nu r is equal to 1 for copper. This is the data. And depth of penetration is delta is equal to 1 divided by under root of pi f mu into sigma, and we have to substitute the data mu as mu naught into mu r. So pi as it is, f value 1 megahertz, 1 into 10 to the power 6, mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, mu r is equal to 1. And conductivity we have to substitute it as 5.8 into 10 to the power 7. Substitute here and then you calculate the value of delta. That is depth of penetration, you will get it as 66.085 micrometer. So this is the depth of penetration. So this is how we will calculate. So in the previous problem, we have calculated the value of depth also, that is depth at which the wave amplitude is decreasing, 13.5%. So in the theory we have done maximum it will decrease up to 37%, and here they have given 13.5%. So this is the depth at which also we have calculated, and here we have calculated only the depth of penetration, that is skin depth. So skin depth value we will get it as 66.085 micrometers. Next example, example number 5. A metal sheet of aluminium has sigma is equal to 38.2 mega and mu r is equal to 1. Calculate the skin depth delta, comma, the propagation constant gamma and velocity of propagation v at a frequency of 1.6 megahertz. So for the given data, aluminium, sigma value, mu r value, we need to calculate the skin depth delta and the propagation constant gamma. Along with that, we need to calculate the value of v velocity. Now, for the metal sheet, let us write the equation. Gamma is equal to, propagation constant is equal to j omega mu sigma. That is j omega. Omega is 2 pi f. Mu is mu naught into mu r. Sigma as it is. Substitute the values of f, sigma and the mu naught. That is j as it is. 2 pi f value is 1.6 megahertz, 1.6 into 10 to the power 6, mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 and the mu r is equal to 1 into conductivity sigma is equal to 38.2 mega, so 38.2 into 10 to the power 6 and calculate the value of propagation constant. So we will get it as j under root of j 4.8258 into 10 to the power 8. 10 to the power 8 is equal to, we will get it as under root of 4.8258 into 10 to the power 8 at an angle of 45 degree. So this is how we have calculated the propagation constant gamma. But still we need to calculate the skin depth delta as well as the velocity of the propagation v. So let us write this propagation constant gamma in terms of alpha plus j beta, and alpha plus j beta is equal to 15.533 into 10 to the power 3 plus j 15.533 into 10 to the power 3. That means we will get alpha is equal to beta. As we have studied in the concept, alpha will be equal to beta, attenuation constant is equal to phase constant. Hence, now the skin depth for aluminium at 1.6 megahertz, we can write it as delta is equal to 1 divided by under root of pi f nu into sigma, or else we can write it as 1 divided by alpha also. As we have calculated the value of alpha, it is better to write delta is equal to 1 by alpha, that is 1 divided by alpha value is 15.533 into 10 to the power 3. We will get skin depth for aluminium delta is equal to 1 divided by 15.533 into 10 to the power 3. I will substitute and I will calculate the value of skin depth. That is depth of penetration, and I will get it as approximately 64.38 micrometers. We will get skin depth as 64.38 micrometers. Then I need to calculate the velocity of propagation also. So we can write velocity of propagation as v is equal to omega by beta. V is equal to omega divided by beta. Omega value is 2 pi f. 2 pi f value is 1.6 into 10 to the power 6. 2 pi f divided by beta. And beta value we have calculated as 15.533 into 10 to the power 3. Substitute the value of beta here. and from this we will get the velocity v is equal to 647.2 meter per second. The velocity of propagation is 647.2 meter per second. We will get the value of v. So that is what I wanted to calculate in this problem. That is the propagation constant, skin depth, as well as velocity of the propagation. So we have calculated all the three. Now let us move to next example. Find the phase and amplitude of electric field at the depth of 0.1 millimeter into a copper sheet relative to that entering surface for a 1 gigahertz wave directed normal to the sheet. So we need to calculate the phase and amplitude of electric field. Both I have to calculate. Frequency is 1 gigahertz and it is a copper sheet. Hence we know conductivity sigma is equal to 5.8 into 10 to the power 7 is the conductivity. Now first we will calculate sigma divided by omega epsilon. Let us check the ratio first. Sigma by omega epsilon. Sigma value is 5.8 into 10 to the power 7 divided by omega is 2 pi f, f value is 1 gigahertz, 1 into 10 to the power 9, and epsilon is epsilon naught into epsilon r, and epsilon r I have considered here as 1, and epsilon naught I will get it as 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12 is the value of epsilon naught. Hence, if I calculate the ratio sigma by omega epsilon, I will get this as 1.0425 into 10 to the power 9. The value I will get ratio sigma by omega epsilon as 1.0425 into 10 to the power 9. Now, this value is very much greater than 1. Hence, at 1 gigahertz, the copper sheet will definitely act as a good conductor, because the ratio we have calculated sigma by omega epsilon is very much greater than 1. Hence now we have proved that it is a good conductor. Now we will find the phase and amplitude of E. So that is, we know that alpha equal to beta is equal to under root of pi f mu into sigma. Pi f, f value is 10 to the power 9. Mu is mu naught into mu r. Mu r I have taken it as 1. And mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. And conductivity sigma value is 5.8 into 10 to the power 7. Now substitute those values and let us calculate the value of alpha and beta first. So alpha is equal to beta, and if you solve this under root term, then we will get it as alpha is equal to beta is equal to 4.785 into 10 to the power 5. The attenuation constant is equal to phase constant is equal to 4.785 into 10 to the power 5. Now, at depth of 0.1 millimeter The amplitude of E is given by? Sir, this general expression for the amplitude E is given by E is Ex is equal to Ex naught into e to the power minus beta z, where Ex naught is amplitude of E at a surface, z is the depth, and beta is the phase constant. Now, we need to calculate the amplitude, that is Ex by Ex naught is equal to e to the power minus beta z, e to the power minus beta value. Beta value is 4.785 into 10 to the power 5 into z value. Z value is 10 to the power minus 4 because they have given us 0.1 millimeter, and I need to calculate, find the phase and the amplitude. So I'm calculating amplitude Ex by Ex naught is equal to e to the power minus beta z. Substitute the value of beta as well as z. And I will get this as 1.6558 into 10 to the power minus 21. The amplitude, if I calculate, I will get it as 1.6558 into 10 to the power minus 21. Now this is the amplitude of E. Now if I want to calculate phase, so phase is nothing but e to the power angle term, that is phase term, that is nothing but beta z term. So phase is equal to beta z is equal to, beta value is 4.785 into 10 to the power 5 into z value is 10 to the power minus 4. So if I calculate this, I will get 47.85 radians is the phase of electric field. So we have calculated the amplitude as well as phase of field. So phase is nothing but beta z, and I will get beta z is equal to 47.85 radians. So this is how we can calculate the amplitude as well as phase. So with this, next example. Wet marshy soil is characterized by conductivity sigma is equal to 10 to the power minus 2, epsilon r is equal to 15, and mu r is equal to 1. Now I need to show that at 60 hertz it can be considered as a good conductor. First one, I need to calculate, or I need to prove that at 60 hertz it should act as a good conductor, and hence at 60 hertz calculate first one skin depth, second one intrinsic impedance, and third one propagation constant. So I need to calculate all these three things at 60 hertz. Now if I want to prove it as a conductor, that means the ratio sigma by omega epsilon should be greater than 1. So let us calculate what is the ratio sigma by omega epsilon is equal to. Sigma by omega epsilon is epsilon naught into epsilon r, and let us substitute all the values. Sigma value they have given as 10 to the power minus 2 divided by omega is 2 pi f, f is 60 hertz into epsilon naught 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, and epsilon r is equal to 50. So if I calculate the ratio, sigma by omega epsilon is equal to, I will get this as 0.1997 into 10 to the power 5. The ratio of sigma by omega epsilon, I will get it as 0.1997 into 10 to the power 5, which clearly indicates the value is very much greater than 1. Hence, definitely considered as a good conductor. Now, I need to calculate the skin depth, the intrinsic impedance, and the propagation constant for this. Now, since it acts as a good conductor, now at good conductor, first one, the propagation constant is given by gamma is equal to under root of j omega mu into sigma, that is under root of j mu sigma at an angle of 45 degree, that is j term. Now I will substitute this, that is omega is 2 pi f, f is 60 hertz, mu is mu naught into mu r, and mu r I have taken it as 1, hence mu naught I will get it as 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, and conductivity value they have given as 10 to the power minus 2 is the conductivity. 10 to the power minus 2 I will substitute, and I will calculate the value of propagation constant gamma, which I will get it as 2.1766 into 10 to the power minus 3 at an angle of 45 degree, or else I can represent propagation constant as alpha plus j beta, which is nothing but 1.539 into 10 to the power minus 3 plus j 1.539 into 10 to the power minus 3, that is nothing but both alpha and beta are equal. Hence, now comparing the real and imaginary terms, we can calculate the value of alpha and beta, and alpha value is 1.539 into 10 to the power minus 3, and beta is also 1.539 into 10 to the power minus 3. So this is the value of alpha and beta we will get, that is the propagation constant. Now I can easily calculate the skin depth. Now skin depth, depth of penetration delta is equal to 1 divided by alpha. So 1 divided by alpha value is 1.539 into 10 to the power minus 3. Substitute alpha value and calculate the depth of penetration in meters. So I'll get it as approximately 649.75 meters. I will get it as 649.75 meter is depth of penetration or skin depth. That is the second one I have calculated. And now third one, that is intrinsic impedance. Now based on our study, we can write the intrinsic impedance eta is equal to 1 divided by sigma into delta plus the complex term j into 1 divided by sigma into delta. So let us substitute both the values, sigma value as well as delta value. Delta value is 649.75 and sigma value, conductivity value, they have given as 10 to the power minus 2. So substitute both the values, sigma value as well as delta value. And if we simplify, we will get intrinsic impedance eta is equal to 0.1539 plus j 0.1539 or else 0.21764 at an angle of 45 degree ohms. So this is the intrinsic impedance what I have calculated in this. So this is how we will calculate the propagation constant, skin depth, as well as intrinsic impedance eta. So let us take one more example to find the surface resistance here. That is, question is example number 8, find skin depth and surface resistance of a copper conductor at 100 megahertz having conductivity sigma is equal to 5.8 into 10 to the power 7 mho per meter, and mu r is equal to 100. So I need to calculate the skin depth as well as the surface resistance. So we know that the skin depth is, so this also can be given as delta is equal to under root of 2 divided by omega mu sigma. So 2 divided by omega is 2 pi f. Mu naught, mu r, sigma. So we will substitute the values. That is 1 divided by pi f mu into sigma is nothing but 1 divided by under root pi as it is. F value is 100 megahertz, 100 into 10 to the power 6 into mu naught, mu r. Mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. Mu r value they have given as 100 into conductivity sigma is 5.8 into 10 to the power 7. Substitute. Delta is equal to, we will get this value, that is skin depth as 6.6085 into 10 to the power minus 7 meters. The skin depth or depth of penetration is given by 6.6085 into 10 to the power minus 7 meters. And also the surface resistance of the copper, that is the surface resistance of a conductor, is given by RS is equal to, where RS stands for surface resistance, is given by 1 divided by delta into sigma, that is 1 divided by delta value is 6.6085 into 10 to the power minus 7, and conductivity sigma is 5.8 into 10 to the power plus 7. So if we solve this, we will get surface resistance RS as 0.02608 ohms. The surface resistance is given by 0.02608 ohms. Now with these many examples, we have learned how to calculate the skin depth, that is nothing but depth of the penetration, along with the surface resistance, propagation constant, attenuation constant, phase constant, how to calculate in skin depth concept. Now with this, let us have some quiz questions. So first one, over a distance d, the amplitude of the wave decreases to approximately dash percent of its original value. That means in case of skin depth, the amplitude of the wave decreases approximately. Is it 35, 37 or 47? Yes, answer is option B, that is 37%. So the amplitude of the wave, since it is e to the power minus term, the amplitude of the wave will start decreasing, and it will decrease us approximately 37% of its original value. That is option B. Let us see second one. That is, for a good conductors, the angle of intrinsic impedance is dash degree. So the intrinsic impedance term, that is eta value, if you see, then the angle is it 35, 43 or 45? Yes, the answer is option C, it is 45 degrees. The option C, it is 45 degrees. So this is what I wanted to cover today. Thank you all. Thank you very much.